Hey, this is Edward Stinger from Videoplasty, and welcome to this tutorial on how to improve your voiceovers in just a couple of minutes by using a free piece of software called Audacity. And don't worry, you don't even have to understand exactly what you're doing. All you have to do is follow the super simple steps and your voiceover is gonna sound 10 times better. In this tutorial, I'm gonna focus more on the post-production and what you do in Audacity, but obviously you want to have the basics covered as well. So you want to use a super high quality microphone. In my case, I'm using the Blue Yeti microphone, which is absolutely amazing. I highly recommend you get one as well. And you know, you might want to add a pop filter in there as well to block some weird sounds like peas and breath and stuff like that. You also want to record in a quiet environment where you don't have like weird sounds coming from other rooms. You don't have people talking in the background. And you want to turn off like fridges, ACs, and you don't want to hear even like the fan of the computer, for example. So let's get started. I'm actually going to record a couple of seconds that we're going to edit, and you'll see the before and after. Hey, this is Edward Stinger, and welcome to another Videoplasty tutorial. Alright, so whenever you record, you want to leave a couple of seconds in the beginning or at the end, doesn't matter, like a buffer time, because you want to use this to see if you have any background noise and to actually do some noise reduction. So let's have a look. Yeah, I'm not sure if you can actually hear that in the YouTube recording, but there is some background noise here. Even if it seems like a flat line, you can actually hear it with headphones. And you want to instruct Audacity. You want to tell Audacity that this is the background noise type that you want to record. It's like a constant in the background. And the way you do that is you go to you select this first of all, and you go to Effect, and go to Noise Reduction. And click on this button right here that says Get Noise Profile, so Audacity can learn about the type of noise that you have in the background. And once you do that, you wanna clean the entire voiceover now. So you just click anywhere to deselect, or just select all of it, then doesn't matter. And go to Effect, Noise Reduction, and just do it again. Actually, no, this time just leave the settings by default as they are here. Doesn't matter too much, and just click OK. And, you know, in our case, the background noise wasn't too bad, but if you have a really bad background noise, the difference is going to be significant. So the next thing you want to do is you want to use compressor. And what that does is it compresses the highs of the recording, so you can amplify the whole thing later without peaking it. And just leave pretty much all of those by default. And the only thing that matters pretty much is just the threshold. You want to have it at like, let's say minus 15 decibels. That should be fine. And let's click OK. All right. And the next part is actually my favorite part in the process. It's equalization. And you want to amplify the highs and the lows a bit. It's just going to, you know, give it some extra richness. It's gonna make it sound like that radio voice, and yeah, it's really cool. So just go here to bass boost, and to be honest, if you're a woman recording a voiceover, you might not want to do a bass boost because it's gonna make your voice sound a bit manlier, but you know, it's up to you. Give it a go, you know, play around with it, see how it sounds. So I'll leave everything else the same, just select bass boost, click OK. And it already did a lot to the voiceover. And let's do that again, equalization. But this time you wanna work with the highs. So just do a treble boost this time. All right. And the final step in the process is you want to normalize the whole thing. And what normalize does is it basically makes it as loud as possible without peaking, as you can see here. So yeah, let's just leave it to minus 1 decibels, that should be fine, and let's click OK. Alright. Now let's give it a go and see how it sounds. Hey, this is Edward Stunga, and welcome to another videoplasty tutorial. Alright, I think that sounds super, super good actually. Now let's check the original recording and see how that sounds. Hey, this is Edward Stunga, and welcome to another videoplasty tutorial. Hey, this is Edward Stunga, and welcome to another videoplasty tutorial. Alright, I think that is a huge improvement, and you know, you can do this as well on your own. It only takes a couple of minutes, and it's definitely worth the effort. Even if you don't understand what you're doing, just follow these super simple steps, and you're good to go. Alright, I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Be sure to hit the like button and subscribe to this channel for more tutorials. And also, really important, be sure to share this tutorial with someone that needs it. Because just doing something as simple as this, as improving the voiceover quality of your video, it's gonna bring the quality of your video to the next level, and it's gonna make it look and sound much more professionally. And yeah, that's pretty much it. This was Edward Stenger from Videoplasty. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you soon.